Shining through the trees, a waft of soft, cool air flits across the moonlit sea. There's a man beside you, a handsome rogue of a fellow. Slowly his arm slips around your shoulders. You feel yourself drawn to him. You feel yourself abandoned. All your inhibitions vanish with the breeze. Romance is in the air and you feel yourself drawn to it. You want to give yourself up to this wild excitement. Every fiber in your being is saying, live, live, live.
Oh, yes, yes.
Oh. I'm a slave to your desires. I'm putty in your hands. Mold me. Fashion me. Kiss me, kiss me.
Do you love me?
Yes, yes, of course I do.
Real love, forever and ever.
Yes, yes, yes.
Real lasting love, like they have on the pictures.
Yes, of course, yes, of course, yes, of course. Now, give yourself out of this moment. Look at me.
No, I'm shy.
Look at me. Can't you see the love hidden in the depths of my eyes? Yearning for you. Crying out for you.
What's the time?
8:15. Anything you want is yours. Just ask.
All right, then. Can I have another drink? I'm as dry as an old boot. Ooh, it's lovely, isn't it? I love cider, don't you?
Cider, what do you mean, cider? This is the finest vintage champagne for me. How did you know it was cider?
Oh, the boys give me cider when I go to parties. They say it gets me going.
Well, come on then, drink it up, my dear. Yes, get it down you, my love.
Yes.
Can't you see tonight the world is ours? Look at me, look at me. What are you giggling at?
Your nose.
What do you mean, my nose? What's the matter with it?
And it makes me laugh.
Makes you laugh? Nothing wrong with it? Come on now, relax. Give yourself up to this overpowering passion.
Can't. Every time I look at your face, I see your nose.
But of course you see me nose. What do you expect to see me elbow? Don't forget about me nose, please. Try and cooperate. Force yourself.
There's no... I can't look at you without laughing. I'm conscious of it, you see. I know it's there.
Well, of course it's there. Why didn't you laugh at it when you first saw it? Why wait till now? I wouldn't have bothered to have had all this laid on here. Half a gallon of the best cider, a box of chocolates. It cost me a fortune, this has.
I've only just noticed it. I didn't pay much attention to it before, but now... it sort of dominates your whole face.
Have a care, madam. You can go too far. All right, forget about the nose. Don't look at it. Close your eyes. We'll try again. I can't let this go. I've got too much invested in it. Now, look, this time, no looking.
All right.
Ah, me wild, hot-blooded beauty. Oh, now what?
It's no good. I can imagine it. I can see it in my mind's eye.
Oh, this is ridiculous. How can you make love to somebody who keeps giggling all the time? Go on, hop it. I'll have me chocolates back as well.
Well, all the cheek. Now we're seeing the other side of your nature. So this is what you're really like, is it?
Yes, it is. Now go on, go home.
Oh, right, I'm going home, don't you worry. And you have got a funny nose. A great big red thing. In fact, I've never seen such a rotten nose in my life.
What a fiasco. Money in the bank, I thought that was. All the girls in London, I have to pick one who's got a thing about noses. Nothing wrong with this. Perfectly good hooter, that is. Bit on the generous side, perhaps, but none the worse for that. Nobody's ever made remarks about it before. I've always been rather proud of it. Rather aquiline, I've always thought. Ah, oh, no, there's a lot worse noses than this walking about.
Come in. Where is she? Where's the bird?
She's gone.
How'd you get on?
I didn't.
You told me you were home and dry.
And so I was.
Well, what happened then?
I don't wish to talk about it.
All right. Sid,
yeah.
We've been friends for many years now, haven't we? Always been frank with each other, never had anything hidden. Always been truthful, haven't we?
Yeah.
I mean, if ever I've asked your opinion about anything, you've always given it to me straight from the shoulder, haven't you?
Yeah.
Sid? What do you think of my nose?
What do you mean, what do I think of your nose?
It's all right, don't worry, I can take it. I don't want you to hide anything from me. I want your honest assessment of the hooter.
Never really thought about it.
Well, look, take a good look at it now. Take your time. Don't rush the diagnosis. I want your honest opinion.
Well, it's all right. You know, it's just like any other nose. Starts between your eyes, finishes up just above your mouth. Got a couple of holes in it. Well, a nose is a nose, isn't it?
That's not good enough. You must tell me, I've got to know. Have I got an ugly nose?
All right, just a minute then. Now stand still. Well, I don't know. It's nothing to write home about, but no nose is it? I don't know what you mean. What do you want me to say about it? It works, doesn't it? The air goes in and out.
Yeah, I know. I'm not interested in the functional efficiency of it. It works very well. Goes like a bomb. It's the aesthetic quality of it I'm worried about. I want your opinion as to the shape of it. Its proportions with regard to the rest of the features.
Oh, well, in that case, it's horrible.
It is not horrible. This is a perfectly good nose.
What did you ask me for then?
Because you're supposed to be a friend.
You asked me what I thought about your hooter, and I told you, it is horrible.
How is it? Is it? Yours isn't exactly a gem of architectural beauty, is it? Look at it, throbbing away there.
Any more observations from you in that particular strain, and I shall fetch you a right punch up the bracket. This, mate, has got character. It has never been insulted before.
I'm sorry, Sid, I shouldn't have said that. It's only because I'm upset. I didn't mean to be offensive.
It's all right, I understand. After all, it's not your fault you've got a hideous hooter.
I have not got a hideous hooter. This is a conspiracy. I've never had a hideous hooter before. Why should I have one now? I'm going out.
Oh, now, look, I'm sorry.
No, thank you. I'm not going to stay here and be insulted by the likes of you. And another thing. Oh!
Biggs's new boyfriend.
Oh, Harold Higgins, isn't he horrible?
I know. I don't know how she can walk down the street with him.
Well, of course, she never did have any ties.
He's so big. I don't know what she can see in him.
Quiet, I know.
Cup of tea and a meat pie, please.
I've seen some funny-looking men in my time, but he's the limit.
Oh, stop it, Elsie. You shouldn't laugh at people.
Well, I can't help it. I wouldn't have the nerve to come out if I looked like him.
It's not his fault, poor thing.
Well, I wouldn't be seen dead with him. I mean, really great big ugly thing. He's the sort of man who shouldn't go out with girls. People must stare at him all the time.
Perhaps he doesn't know.
Of course he does. You can't look like that and not know. Well, I wouldn't go out with him, I'll tell you that.
And you wouldn't get the chance, you coffee-ass Jezebel.
Have you been to the circus yet, then?
No, I've seen it on television, though.
Oh, what did you think of that clown?
Oh, very funny. Grotesque, isn't he?
Oh, he's a scream to look at, isn't he? What about that nose, oh, then?
Fantastic, isn't it? Like a great red tennis ball on the end of his face. Yes.
He lives around here, I understand.
Does he really?
Yes, I've never met him, though.
I can't help laughing every time I think of his nose.
Times you're driving me right at the wall. I keep telling you it doesn't make any difference what kind of a nose you've got.
I realize now I was never much of a hand with the ladies. What's this? Puts them off. I always thought it was because I was so good looking they thought they didn't stand a chance with me. I know now. It's the nose. Just a figure of fun. That's
what. Oh, now you're exaggerating again.
No, I'm not. I've heard him. I've heard him talking. A great big red tennis ball on the end of his face. No, I've decided, Sid, I shall never set foot outside this house again.
Oh, now, turn it up. If everybody stayed indoors because of their noses, we'd have a country full of hermits.
No good. I've made up my mind. I shall become a recluse. I shall just stay here and get old and bitter.
Now, you please yourself, mate. I'm going out. Anything I can get you?
Yes, take the handcart down to the grocer's and bring back half a ton of tin food. I shall be here for a long time.
What do you want today?
Half a pint. Leave it on the step.
It's Saturday, Mr. Hancock. Would you like to pay for the rest of the week? It's 2 and 9, please.
Oh, hang on a minute.
Thank you. Yeah. 2 and 9, 3 shillings, 5, 7 and 6, 10, and 10 is 20.
Thank you.
Have I done anything to upset you, Mr. Hancock? Why don't you open the door to me anymore these days?
Mind your own business.
Oh, blimey, what a country this is. Oh, boss, turn the man, can't get a drink.
What do you want, Sid?
I don't know.
What about a milkshake?
Oh, do me a favour.
Raspberry, strawberry, blackcurrant.
Give me a glass of milk. Don't fill it up. Oh, that's better. What's the matter with you?
Haven't you noticed anything about me, Sid?
No.
Go on, you must have a good look.
You've had your hair cut.
Nah, look, can't you see anything?
No.
The nose.
Oh, blimey, yes. What have you done to it? You used to have the biggest hooter in East Cheam. Where's it gone?
I had it done.
What do you mean, done?
Plastic surgery, had a bit chipped off it. Marvellous, innit?
Boy, that's fantastic. Used to be twice that size. Must have cost a bomb.
National Health. Doctor said it was affecting me. He was giving me a complex. It was affecting my mental stability. So he gives me a chit and I go along and have it done. I've got bags of confidence now. I'm a new man. I divorced my wife, got a new one.
Plastic surgery, of course. That's what Hancock needs. Do you know that he hasn't been out of the house for 2 weeks? Because some stupid bird told him he had a funny ooter?
Well, has he?
Oh, it's the same as anybody else's. There's thousands of ooters like his. But he's sensitive. He's shut himself off from the world. He's gone all temperamental. Sits in a dark room all day. I think he saw Betty Davis do it in a film or something.
Maybe I can help him. If he sees what they've done for me, he might feel better.
Won't listen to anybody. He doesn't want human eyes to gaze on the mockery that was once her face.
Yeah. I know how he feels. I used to be like that myself. The stares of the people over the tops of their hot pies. Only somebody what's suffered knows what he's going through. Sid, I consider it my duty to help. This poor wretch
yes,
has
yes,
been...
Yes, 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 all right, don't go on. Let's go see it. Must be in a right state. Every mirror in the house is in here. You must have got jealous.
A recognisable symptom. I used to be like that. Couldn't stand anything with a pretty nose.
Yeah, will you come and wait in the hall? I'll tell him you're here.
Turn it out! You know, I can't stand a naked light. Turn it out!
Got me. There's a bloke here who wants to talk to you.
I can't see him. You know I can't bear people to see me. Show him out. I won't see him. I won't...
Pull yourself together. What's the matter with you? You've got to talk to this bloke because he wants to help you. Now, come on.
Hang on a minute. Who is it?
You remember Arthur Dilwater used to work down in the milk bar?
Yes.
Do you remember his nose?
Yes, if I remember correctly, it was a Jimmy Durante with a Serrano de Bergerac on the end of it.
Wait till you see this. Arthur, come in.
It can't be true. He used to be out here.
What is it? What have you done with it?
Plastic surgery. I had it reshaped.
And this is marvellous. You look a completely different person.
Yeah, and what it's done for me, it can do for you. Now, if you're so self-conscious about your nose, why don't you go and see a plastic surgeon and have it altered?
No, I couldn't do that. It'd, I don't know, feel daft. It doesn't seem natural.
Of course it is. Lots of people do it these days. Actors, singers, they're all having it done.
Of course, it'd be marvellous, mate. Make a new man and you'll give you back all your old confidence.
Be a sensation with a woman.
You think so?
What? On a pally on a Friday night in your slim gym and your tapered trousers, your dance card will be full for weeks.
Never thought of plastic surgery.
You can choose any shape nose you like.
Yes. Yes, I could have a Robert Taylor or a Burt Lancaster or a David Niven with just the tiniest hint of Rosano Brazzi about the nostrils.
You certainly could.
Did it hurt?
Didn't feel a thing. And the nurses, oh boy, when I came round, they took off the bandages. Oh, you had to beat them off with bed trays.
Well, who did it then? Who was the man?
I've got his card here somewhere. First-class bloke, specialises in noses. Here we are.
Oh. Dr. Francis Worthington, plastic surgeon. I don't know, I haven't made up my mind up yet.
My wife wants me to have it done like Elvis Presley. Personally speaking, I prefer it as the French say, retrousseau.
Yes, I think it'd be very attractive.
Of course, my conk don't suit my job.
Oh, what do you do?
I'm a commercial television announcer.
Mr. Hancock here?
Hancock, yes, that's me.
Dr. Worthington will see you now.
Oh, thank you very much.
Mr. Hancock.
Oh, sit down, will you please, Mr. Hancock?
Oh, my God.
No, please, please. Please, Mr. Hancock, please come back. I do apologize. Please forgive me, but you rather took me by surprise.
Well, I should have thought you'd have got used to it. I mean, you of all people. Somebody in the trade.
I'm so sorry. Please sit down and make yourself comfortable. Now then, let's have a look at your problem, shall we? Let's see now. Oh, dear me, yes. Yes, this is going to be quite a challenge, isn't it? Are you a port drinker?
No, I am not a port drinker.
No, please, please. No offence, Mr. Hancock, but I simply must ask these questions. Now, what sort of thing had you in mind?
Oh, you know, just something serviceable, nothing ostentatious, a bit off here and there. Nothing flashy, of course.
Well, I think I'm the best judge of that.
I'm sorry.
I'm a man for my good taste.
Yes, of course. I apologize.
Well, now, perhaps you'd like to have a look through the pattern book.
Bow me. Now,
I expect there's something here that might appeal to you.
Yes.
Now, where are we now? Now, this one here.
Yes. Yes. That's quite a good one. That's what you might call a straight-up nadana.
Well, in the profession, we call it aquiline.
Aquiline? That means you can use it underwater, doesn't it? Very good for spear fishing, I should think.
No, that's not what it means. Do you like it? It's a very trustworthy nose, very popular with businessmen.
No, I don't think so.
Well, we can always adapt the style to suit the features.
No, I don't know. It's a very nice nose. I've nothing against it as a nose, and I'm sure you do a beautiful job on it, but I don't somehow think it's me.
As you wish. Now, here's rather an attractive one. Of course, this goes rather better with glasses. Do you wear glasses?
No, I'm afraid I don't.
Oh, it's a pity.
Yours is a nice one. Who did that?
nature.
Oh, I do beg your pardon.
Mr. Hancock, I do hope you're not trying to be funny.
Oh, no, heaven forbid I am.
Shall we continue?
Yes, please do. Carry
there on. Must be plenty of others here. Now, this one here would appear to be very much your style of nose. Mm. Now, this is the latest thing in from Italy, the Roman nose. It's very, very much in vogue at the moment. It goes so well with the short jackets and pointed shoes.
Yes. Yes, it's very Mark Antony, that, isn't it? But a bit of Charlie Chester chucked in as well. Now, I think I'm a bit too full in the face to carry anything like that, you know, really. Looks all very well on paper, but haven't you got any sort of models I could try on?
Oh, yes, yes, certainly, certainly I have, yes. Now, then, let's have a look at some of these, shall we? There must be something here that might appeal. Now, this one here, now, this is the broad-nostrilled model.
Mm-hmm.
Just try that for size,
will
you?
It's a bit tight.
Well, yes, it is only a model. I assure you, your own nose won't be tight.
No, I don't think so. It's not me, you know. I'm sorry.
Well, very difficult to please, aren't you? Now, this one here, this is the traditional Greek nose.
Huh?
Let's try that, will you?
Mm.
There we are.
There we are. Yes.
Now, that looks... that looks extremely well on the rugger field. Are you a rugger man?
No, I'm not.
Not for you, then. Just try that one, will you?
Yes, certainly.
I do beg your pardon. I don't know how that got there. We keep that one for office parties.
Oh, never mind. Just put it on one side. I can use it in my stage act. Well, I don't know. You don't really seem to have anything to suit me, you know. I want something firm, straight, bags of character with the old flaring nostrils there. Something aristocratic, sort of Scarlet Pimpernelish.
Yes, yes, yes. I think you're right. Yes, something elegant, something suitable for every occasion.
Quite, quite.
Well, I don't think I've got a model of that, but I think I could possibly knock one up for you. 24 BWX fitting with a modified Spanish bridge. That's the one, I think.
Oh, yes, yes, that sounds more like it, yes.
Yes, well, we'll get you measured up straight away. Nurse? Nurse, will you take these measurements for me, please? Width of bridge, 5/8. Base of nose, 1 1/8.
Oh, do you mind if I have 1 1/4 there? I like a wide fitting.
Make that 1 1/4, will you, nurse, please? Length of nose, 1 7/8. We can always let it down a bit if it's not long enough. Now, finally, colouring. What do you think?
Oh, I don't know, something about the same shade as the face, eh?
As you wish. Pasty white. Well, now, the next thing is the operation, Mr. Hancock. Are you free next Tuesday?
Yes, yes.
All right. Well, nurse, will you put Mr. Hancock down for next Tuesday, please? Ward B.
Thank you, Doctor. You're doing great work. How is he, Doctor?
The operation's been a complete success. I'm very pleased with him.
Oh, that's marvelous. When's he coming home?
Well, it's up to him, really, but he'll have to... He can take the bandages off in a couple of days.
Oh, you've been absolutely marvelous.
Ah, not at all, not at all. It's all part of the dedicated service provided by dedicated men. A profession in all in which we are all proud to have the privilege to serve. 100 guineas, please.
Yes, I'll send you some. I'm going home to get everything fixed up for him.
What's the time?
5 to 12.
Come on, let's take it off now.
No, no, no. Doctor said the plaster mustn't come off till 12 o'clock.
Look, it won't make any difference. Let me have a look at it.
No!
Just a little peek.
Get off! You break it!
Haven't you got any idea at all what it looks like?
No, I haven't. Sid.
Yes?
I'm frightened. I'm scared, Sid. It's not natural what I've done. Playing with the unknown, it doesn't seem right.
Of course it's right. You're not the first one.
Suppose it's a failure. Suppose it's worse than the other one. I shouldn't have done it. You can't tamper with nature. Vanity, that's what it was. One of the 7 deadly sins, vanity. Can't mess about with things beyond our ken. That was the right nose. That was the nose I was supposed to have. There was nothing wrong with it. I've just been a vain fool and I want my old looter back.
It's all right. You haven't done any wrong. Blimey, you're still the same pure lily-white flower you always have been. 12 o'clock. Stand by Cinderella for the transformation scene.
Sid, I'm scared. I'm juicing scared.
All right, now take it easy, boy. Nothing to worry about. Here we go. What a smasher!
Is it all right?
Is it all right? It's sensational. What a difference.
You're joking.
Don't touch it! It's a work of art.
Well, give me the mirror then. Let me have a look at it. It's marvellous. I'm handsome, Sid.
Yes. I'm not kidding you. I never saw such a conk. You'll murder those women now.
Oh, you handsome devil.
Not bad, eh? You'll see who's the master now. Laugh at me nose, would they? Well, the women of England have had it now. I shall show no mercy. The worm has turned.
Do you like the music?
Yes, it's lovely. Makes you want to lay back and relax.
Well, then just lay back and relax.
Let the music seep into you and let it transport you.
Close your eyes. Think of a hot summer's night. The moon shining through the trees. A waft of soft cool air drifts across the moonlit sea. There's a man beside you, a handsome rogue of a fellow.
What's the matter with you? What's the matter with me nose?
Nothing. I think you've got a lovely nose. Why?
Well, what are you laughing at then?
It's your ears.
Hello. Could you give me East Cheam 610, please?
Stick out like jug handles.
Stick out like jug handles.
Flap about like cab doors.
Hello, Dr. Worthington. Yes, it seems to be me ears. Like jug.